Thank you very much, and good evening, everybody. It's a great pleasure to be here at this fantastic event, one of the highlights of the annual Barclays calendar. Now, in 2010, we added a Male Diversity Champion Award to the Women of the Year program. And this year, we've again asked our female nominees to vote for a male colleague who has encouraged them to reach their potential and created a working environment that's enabled them to flourish. And we have three finalists in this category, and they are Atul Batdagda, Chief Operating Officer, Barclays Africa, Kenya. Now, Atul's commitment to gender diversity and keen support of the Kenyan's Women Network Forum is well recognised. He provided the finance and logistics to establish a lactation room for mothers returning to work from maternity leave in Barclays, Kenya. This initiative has had an overwhelmingly positive impact on helping women manage their work-life balance. Secondarily, Greg Chow, Managing Director, Global Head of Real Money Sales, FX, Barclays Capital, the United States. In his role managing the FX sales desk, Greg constantly looks for opportunities to hire and develop female colleagues. Greg also advocates and encourages mentoring among team members. Though women are often underrepresented in his area of business, they are now a significant proportion of the sales force thanks to his efforts. Finally, Daniel Luz, HR trainee, Europe Retail and Business Banking, Portugal. Daniel was selected to collaborate in the Build a Great Place to Work program because of his enthusiasm and commitment to diversity. He has since developed and implemented initiatives that encourage awareness of issues for working parents, including a partnership with local healthcare and childcare centres to ensure that employees can benefit from discounts on the cost of looking after their children. And the winner for this award, voted by the Women of the Year nominees, is Atul Batdagda. Well done, Atul. And here's a short film of Atul's achievements.
I got involved with the Women's Network Forum when it was first started in Kenya more than a year back. It's a good, important forum where you can get to know what the requirements of women colleagues are.
There's a need to have a lactation room because in Kenya the maternity leave is only 3 months. So you come back before you've breastfed your child enough.
When this particular initiative came across, it was an instantaneous decision. I didn't have to think twice about it. It's an enabler for new mothers to be able to balance their work and home life.
For me, he's been sensitive enough to provide a place for me to still work, be productive. It shows that he feels with the women.
For us, we really feel cherished and encouraged to know that our managers really take care of us and put our interests in their heart.
I think some other heads of other departments should copy from him.
That's a man who's actually thinking about the welfare of women in the company, and I think that's a really, really nice thing for him to do for us, and we're very grateful.
It's made me feel really on top of the world, how a small change can create such a big wave. We have seen the benefit and seen the workplace morale go up, and we're definitely going to replicate it in a number of places.
What Atul has done is remarkable, and I have no doubt that this will be an example to many of our male colleagues to do similar activities to help the cause of our female colleagues within workplace.
Thank you, Atul. I just want to thank you for the baby Igor room. Because of you, now I'm able to feed my baby on breast milk, and look at how big he's become. Thank you. God bless you.
Well done. You're very proud. That's what it's going to get.
I think it said baby eagle on the lactation room. What a great piece of branding that is. And